Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we'll talk about the culture or the Islamic culture or the Oriental culture of building the houses in Cairo, where I used to live at that time, at the end of 19th century, the houses, as well as the beginning of the 20th century. The first house I'm going to describe is my grandfather's house in Cairo. It was a huge house, and the gate was about 4-5 meters high, about 3-4 meters wide, because they used to have the carts coming with the materials, with the seeds, with the goods, to store it in the house there. And within this big gate is a smaller gate for the people to come in through that. And when you come into the house, and the first room on the right hand side is for the guardman, and the second and the third room on the left hand side, this will be for the storehouse or the warehouse, which could keep all the material there. There was a big garden inside the house, and this huge garden was actually for the children to play, because the children were not allowed to come outside the house, because Souq al-Salah Street was a high street and was very busy, and the women were actually very, very scared to let the children to come outside the house. Inside the house would be on the ground floor, the first floor, and the second floor, first and second floor, where the families are living there, where the woman used to observe the children either when they play in the garden from the window, the wooden window, or which had window shutters. This window shutter, or what you call it in English, window projecting from the upper story of the house, it does allow the woman to observe the people walking or passing by in the street, but does not allow the people walking in the street to see the woman sitting behind what we call it in Arabic, mashrabiya. This was the big house, the big family house of my mother's father, Al-Jirisi family, in Souq al-Salah. The second one was exactly the same but smaller style, which was one of my aunties in a place called Zara'an Nawa. It was actually, the gate was ordinary gate, about maybe 3 meters height, maybe 2 meters wide, and with an iron handle. You can keep knocking the door with the iron handle, and the woman will come out from the mashrabiya, which is the wooden shelter in the first and second floor, to look at who is downstairs. And when they found that the one downstairs, some people that they know, they pull the rope and open the gate. When you come inside the gate, there's also a big hall for the children to play, and also the guardman, the guard's room, as well as the store room there. So this will observe the Islamic culture of not mixing men and women when they come to the house, and not allow the people passing by to see the woman if they open the window and look at the people passing by in the street. When we moved from the family house to the flats, my grandma's flat in a place called Yakaniya was a 4-bedroom flat, and the first door or the first room on the left hand side when you come there, it was made for actually the guests, the foreign people, when they come to the flat. And actually, so they are isolated from the people of the flat, and but the huge hole in the middle, which let the children to play in the middle in the flat, or of course the bedrooms and other things actually are at the back of the flat. In our flat in Al-Halmiya at that time, our flat has two doors. One door was actually for an isolated room for the guest. We call it the guest room or the traveler's room. And this is connected to a dining room. But the other room, the other door, is going straight to the family rooms, where actually the people of the house, of the flat, come in to the woman, and the relatives come there. So two doors were there to observe the Islamic etiquette. One door for the guests, the room, and the other one for the family door for the family room. This was the observation of the people, how they used to observe the Islamic culture of not mixing men and women at that time. Thank you very much for watching the video. Please press the notification bell, share it with your friends. Thank you very much.